this is Bronislava for Handmade Rukodielky. And how about if you would like to go and knit a very easy poncho shrug? Easy, just knit stitch, cast on, bind off, couple increases, and you have this poncho slash shrug. You can go and see how it looks in the back. Okay, so what do you say? Should we go and do it? This project is going to be fun, and you can go and adjust it to your size, okay? As you see, I have a sample over here. I knitted 10 stitches with a, this is a cotton yarn, Noro, actually. I got it on sale. I was so excited. It is a, it doesn't say, I think it's like number four, somewhere between number three and number four yarn, okay? Weight, what I'm talking about is weight. And I absolutely, this is gonna be great for a beach, a throw over the shoulders for the beach. And it's gonna be very, very easy to do for, even for beginners, all right? Beginners that already know how to do a knit stitch and how they know how to decrease or increase, actually, in this case, okay? As you see, it's going to be knitted on a very thick needles, and you can choose your needles. I have these are my biggest one, size 15, and it's going to be just knit. And I started on 10 stitches over here. This is my sample. I'm gonna be starting on different number of stitches. I need 16 inches. So 16 inches is times 4. So this I have to do times 4. So I have to start on 40 stitches. Okay. And at the end, I'm actually going to end up with more stitches than 40. I'll be increasing stitches to make it wider on one end. And my length is going to be about 42 inches long. Okay, so this has to be 16 inches, the width. And then the length has to be about 40, 42. And you will have to go and do your own according to your body. And I'll actually explain everything on my blog, all my ideas that how I'm designing this piece, okay? So I will start on 40 stitches. And if I would want to have it a little longer, and actually this is measured from your neck to the elbow, okay, over the shoulder down your arm, and I measured that I need about 16 inches to a little bit over my elbow. So this is what I'm doing right now. I have 16 inches in that area, and I need to cast on 40 stitches. I decided to go and do four more. It's gonna be a little bit longer. 2, 3, 4, okay, a little bit more down my over the shoulders down my arm. And now we just will knit several rows, many rows, with just a knit stitch, all right? So just knit, okay? Let me show it to you also in English style. And we just will wrap the yarn, okay, and knit. This is gonna be so exciting. I mean, it's so easy. It's really easy, and it's going to be very airy. It's gonna kind of look like lace because it will have big holes in it because we're working with a really big needles. So it's not going to be anything elaborate, great even for beginners, even, you know, just something very easy when you don't want to work on something much elaborate, even, you know, really for people who already know how to knit. And I love this cotton yarn, it's wonderful. And it has really nice color, great for beach or, you know, sitting at a cafe, sipping champagne on a sunny day, right? So just knit many, many, many rows. So make about 20 inches, you know, 15 to 20 inches. It depends how big you are. If you're small, you know, 15 or 18 inches long rectangle, you know, in length, okay? And then we will start adding. I mean, you can go and make it really to your specifications, how you want it. There is really, you're not gonna be doing anything wrong here because this is so easy to do. And then we will sew one side to another. Okay, so when I have about 20 inches long strip, I will show you what I will be doing next. I am back with my about 20 inch, almost 21 inch long rectangle. My next step, what I have to do is to start increasing. I will be increasing on just one side, okay? And I already marked my my first row where I will increase. And this marker is also to let me know on what side I will be increasing, okay? I also wanted to mention that I've been slipping every last stitch. I was not knitting it, okay? So when I knit my first stitch, I have to go through the back loop, I knit my stitch, and I continue. And now we will increase, and I will increase actually the way that I will go into the stitch below my next stitch, okay? I will grab it and I pull it through, and then I will knit my second stitch over here on my needle. So this way I will add one stitch, okay? And now I will knit, including this row, I will knit 10 rows, and then I will, in my 11th row, I will do this increase again, okay? So I will just, actually, let me go and show it to you how to increase in, also in English style. So I'll take all, so since I'm not knitting my last stitch, you see like this, okay? I didn't knit it, I just slipped it. I just slipped it from this needle over here, okay? That was my last stitch. And now we need to go and knit the first stitch through the back loop. So I'll put it in there through the back loop, grab my yarn. And now we will increase. And again, I will go in here, okay? Put my needle in there, wrap my yarn, pull the yarn through. That's my increase, and now I will knit my next stitch that I, you know, I was supposed to knit the, right after the first one, okay? And I have increased by one stitch. And now I will knit 10 rows, including this one, okay? Oops, look, it fell off. Okay, I got it. And when I finish my 10 rows, in the next 11th row, I will increase exactly the same way like I increased over here. Okay, exactly the same way. So this, basically this side is gonna start going in an angle. Okay, so basically repeat this, what I just told you, 7 times, and then when I am done with my 7 times increases, which I will mark so you can go and see what I've done, okay? I will mark my every increase that I will make every 10 rows, 7 times. And then I will show you how to finish the this piece. This very fun, interesting, grungy look. And this is really great for fashion forward people, okay? Okay, look, I already have, so here I am, I have done my 7 increases, and let me show you. So here is my increase number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I knitted a few more rows, actually 6, because each of these represent 2 rows since I'm slipping my stitches. And I will do actually one more increase because it measures about 36 inches right now. So I'm going to go right now and knit 4 more rows. I finished my 4 more rows. Okay, so it's going to be another increase, which is going to be my 8th increase. And I will mark it right here that this is my last stitch. And that in my next row, I am going to do an increase. So I will knit my first stitch through the back loop, and then I will increase by knitting underneath this last underneath this second stitch right there, right here. Okay, so that's my increase, and I will knit my next stitch in a regular way. And I decided to knit 4 more rows along the side in here and then buttoned like this. Okay, you can do that, but I am abandoning my idea because I don't personally like the idea how I planned it in my head. Okay, my vision was prettier than actual thing. So that's what I think that I will do. So I am frogging it. I'm frogging it all the way here, and then I will knit 4 more rows and then bind off. So I'm frogging my knit very gently. Now we need to start putting it back on to our needle. And I usually do it like this, from the back, from the back, from the back. Okay, I got rid of my buttonholes and I am ready to bind off. And I will sew it to my side. That's what I will do. Okay, so we knit 1, we knit 2nd, and we pull it over and make it really loose, okay? Because you don't want it to be too squished in here. And knit and pull over and make that stitch long, and notice how long you're making it. Okay, so it's not too long and it's not too short. Okay, look, and if it starts getting too tight in here, this stitch, by, you know, like pulling this, look, you see, that's no good. Okay, so So you need to stretch it out again. Okay. Otherwise it would be too narrow right here. You don't want it narrow. You want it, you know, nicely spread out, just like the bottom. Just like this bottom over here. You know, it's nice and loose also, okay? So you want this end to be the same way, nice and loose. So make them, you know, loose stitches, loose bind off, okay? And another one. You knit one and you pull this one over and make this longer. And check occasionally if they are about the same. You see my stitches are about the same, okay? I moved down here on the floor so I could explain everything, what is going on. So this is my rectangle. This is where we increased our stitches, okay? This is the side that we need to sew to this area right here, and this part is going to be opening for our head, and this is going to be our poncho corner. So this corner actually needs to go and start being sewn to this corner, okay? And this corner is going to end up somewhere in here. So what we need to do is we need to distribute these stitches, all these stitches, along this area right here, so it kind of matches up really nicely. And also, so we do have enough space for our head, you know, to go through this opening, okay? So let me go and actually move this edge over here so you have some kind of visual idea. So this is what we need to do, like this, okay? So as you see, this is going to be our head, the opening for our head, okay? This is going to be our back. This is going to be our front. Okay, and this needs to be sewn or crocheted together, your choice. So what needs to be done now is we need to pin this side to this side. So we have these stitches distributed fairly evenly along this side, right? And how I will do it is that I will go and put this corner together with this corner, then this corner with this side up here somewhere, and I will actually kind of lift it up, these two pieces, and see if they're hanging about the same. And if you go and see from this side is a little lower, you see? So now I know that it's longer, so I will move this corner here, where is the neck area, a little lower, and see if that will go and help out. Okay, and they seem to go and hang about the same way. So what I will do now is I will pin them. So I will lay them nicely and I will go and get my pins and I will pin them just as it is right now. I'll pin them in here, okay, and then I will start crocheting them. And I have this yarn here, so I will start from here going down. I have this yarn finished, you know, when I finished my casting off or binding off over here, I will stop basically from the head or neck area going down this way. And I will crochet. But if you want to sew it instead of crocheting, then
you will need to go and cut off this yarn, string it into your needle, and don't forget to leave really long tail. I would probably, you know, I will do at least maybe this much. I would go and do cut off, okay, about almost double the size. You never know how much you need. And then I would sew it carefully around the edges.
So I pinned my side and the bind off area, okay, and now I'm ready to crochet these two sides together. And I just wanted to point something, you know, because I was always slipping my last stitch. So this is this is going up as I'm knitting up, okay? So these are like really long stitches in here, but my bind off stitches are a little shorter. So I just need to go and make sure that these stitches go and kind of correspond with each other. So I'll just use my judgment and do my best to crochet it together, and so it does not look really weird, okay? And you might have to do the same either way if you're gonna crochet or knit. Now this is my size 6 hook, but let me see if I will be able to get into this. Yes, you see this looks like a chain, right? You see it like a chain thing. So I need to get into each of these. I think I will have to take a smaller hook. Oh, maybe not. Yeah, it will get in. Okay. And then on this side also I have a chain. Okay. I will go through inner chains. And actually here I have to just go through the stitch like this. This is my last stitch that I bind off. And I will crochet this together. Actually, you know what? I will have to go through these over here, through both. I think it would be a little bit too much. Okay. And I will make a chain stitch in here and tighten it up so, you know, it's not too wide. Look. Okay, we can go and take this one out now, that pin. And we can start. So I will go actually through two of these and match it, kind of go in a 90 degree, in a 90 degree. So I have to go through this one more time and next stitch over here, and we will slip stitch it. I will slip stitch it, and now I will go through the next one over here, and I will go through this stitch right here. Okay, that's my next stitch from when I bind off. And as I am looking, I will need to go through one more over here because it kind of matches up. And since I'm doing two in the same one, then these stitches must be a little, you know, not so long, okay? Now I'll go in here, this one, and this is my next one. I might even have to go and switch to a, you see, so my stitches match. These stitches match my bind off area. So here I will have to go one more time into the same stitch and outer stitch right here. Okay. So it looks almost like I have two stitches from my bind off area to one stitch from my side. And you know, and I'm gonna be looking if it's not pulling too much. It doesn't pull. It's okay. So here is my one, and So I'm going again into this one because it's a longer one than these on the other side. So I go twice to that one. Take the pin out. And if you would be sewing, you just would sew along these two edges. Okay? You just would go and have them together and sew them together. But I prefer doing it this way. Okay, you see it's not pulling. Just make them long enough so they don't pull. And let's go and see how it looks right now. So it looks like this. Okay? It's not bad. Looks pretty good. Okay, so I will continue like this, and when I'm finished, I will just model it for you, okay?
We are yet again at the end of my video. All my ends, loose ends, are weaved in. And as you see, I am wearing my poncho shrug very proudly. Because it's made out of a Japanese cotton, very, very soft yarn. And that's it. Again, I want to thank you very much for watching my videos, subscribing, commenting. Thank you, and I will see you another time.